I don't think I've been this excited about a piece of hunting gear probably ever. And if you saw the title of the video, you know what this is about. Let's open these bad boys up. I have been eyeing these Sig binos for quite a while now, and I finally broke down and just bought a pair. Super excited to test these out. But let's do a little unboxing and see what we got. Okay, so right out of the box, we have a warning and some instructions. And here they are. They do come in a padded case with, I assume, a neck strap or something. But that's everything in the box. So put this away. And here's the case they come in. Let's see what we got. So first impressions right off the bat, these things are incredibly lightweight and small. I opted for the 16 power, and pairing these to a pair of 15s, you can see size-wise a lot smaller, and weight-wise there is a huge difference. So right off the bat, smaller, lighter, quality looks pretty good. I'm not seeing anything major here, but let's get some batteries in this. I believe it takes one AA, and let's test it out. So these binos have two modes, two stabilization modes. The first is scan mode, and that's really made for scanning over large chunks of area to look for animals. And then once you find one, it has a target mode that you can switch on real quick, and that gives you even more stabilization. And I'm finding that to be significantly more stable and steady than the scan mode, but both are pretty cool. Now to switch it into these different modes, there's a little lever here on top, and to switch into the first mode, all you do is you're just going to press that lever in, and it is in scan mode. And to get to target mode, what you do is you're just going to flip the lever real quick and then back down. Within 2 seconds is what it says, and you're in target mode. And you can tell the difference of what you're in. There's a little light right here. I don't know if you can see that. If it's green, it's in scan mode. And if it's like this orange color, it's in target mode. All right, guys, we are back home. Just wanted to run out real quick and test them out. And so far, pretty happy with them. These are the 16 powers. These binos are available in 10s, 12s, 16s, and 20s. I decided to go with the 16s. But before I ordered these, I had a few concerns about these binos. Now that I've got them in my hand, I kind of wanted to touch on those. The first major concern I had with these was the overall durability. If I drop these, are they still going to work? You know, how durable are they going to be with this weird design? And while I obviously can't really test that, I don't want to purposely damage these things, I will say the overall build quality seems pretty good. I don't see anything that's kind of give me any cause for concern. So hopefully that quality translates to durability, but that's something I'm going to keep an eye on. Now, the next major concern I had was overall ergonomics. How comfortable are these things to hold or to carry? How easy are the controls to get to? Very small, very lightweight, going to be a breeze to carry, a breeze to glass with all day long without a tripod. Controls, as I mentioned earlier, super easy to get to and use. No issues there, better than expected. Now, the last major concern I had was the optical quality. How do these stack up to other binoculars that I already own? Where are they gonna fit? Pretty happy on that front. I do intend to make some future videos and getting these on a tripod, comparing them side by side with some other binoculars so I can get a better idea of the actual quality. But from what I saw into my eyes right now, very clear glass, very crisp, very happy with the edge-to-edge clarity. Overall, I don't think there's any problems with the quality of the glass, and for the money, pretty hard to beat. Even while you're using the image stabilization modes, overall, the image looked really clean and crisp. So overall, first impressions, pretty happy so far, but I will be doing a follow-up video on these things, comparing them to other binos, as well as one after I put these things through the rounds, put some wear and tear on them to see how well they hold up, and to see if my thoughts and feelings change down the road after actually using them in the field. So if you have any questions for me, any comments about these binos, anything you want to see, leave me a comment down below, and we'll see you in the next one.